Hi, I'm Alyssa Ford Morrell. I'm an extension master gardener with the Master Gardeners of Northern Virginia, here today to talk about an invasive plant, Lesser Celandine or Ficaria verna, this little yellow flower here. However, before we start that, I want to make sure that we're all on the same page about what an invasive plant is. It's not just a plant that spreads too much in your garden and gets annoying, but instead it was formally defined first in 1999 when President Clinton signed Executive Order 13112, and later President Obama amended it in 2016 when he signed Executive Order 13751. And those executive orders together first say that an invasive organism is not native in the location where it is occurring. And then it is able to spread and cause harm to either the environment or the economy, or harm to human, animal, or plant health. We're here at our local stream in Arlington, 4 Mile Run. The plant that we're talking about today, Lesser Celandine, is very much associated with water. Not only does it like a lot of water and thrives, particularly in wet areas, but it also travels by water. Small parts of the plant break off when there's a rise in the water. Or it just breaks off and goes down in the rain, gets into the stream, rides away, and wherever it lands, it forms a new colony. And when I say colony, I really mean it because it likes to spread. Once any little tiny piece of this plant hits the ground, it will root and start forming quite a dense mat of roots. And therein lies the problem. It's such a thick mat and it covers such large expanses that it really interferes with our native spring ephemerals in particular that should be able to be flourishing in the same areas. And they can't make it through this thick mat of roots of this plant. And unfortunately, this is a plant where even when you try to dig it out, you'll leave little bits behind. And those little bits can root anywhere. If they get loose, they'll move around and settle in and become this thick carpet that's very pretty when it's in bloom. I give it credit for that, but it's an environmental problem. Lesser Celandine, which is also known as Fig Buttercup, has masses of flowers in the early spring, as you can see here. And that's a problem because it draws our pollinators away from our native ephemerals that generally don't occur in this mass. Getting rid of Lesser Celandine once there's an infestation is quite challenging. If you've just got one plant or a small area, you can dig it out and probably dig out a lot of the soil with it and just realize that you're going to lose some of that soil because you risk leaving any little part of those roots in the ground and it will regenerate. Other than digging out, you need to go with an herbicide in order to get rid of Lesser Celandine. I had the unfortunate experience a few years ago where my next door neighbor got some plants planted in their yard that had some Lesser Celandine in the pots with them. They didn't realize at the time it was planted in the fall, but when spring came, here were all these little yellow flowers that I quickly recognized and pointed out to them. They were willing to work with me. They agreed they didn't want it there, but we couldn't dig those plants out. And so I worked on identifying, I did some research using the site:edu extension to my search term to identify a good herbicide. I followed the label instructions and applied the herbicide to the lesser celandine very carefully, keeping it away from the plants that the neighbors wanted to keep. The problem with lesser celandine is that it is ephemeral, meaning that it's going to die away pretty soon anyway. And so we couldn't tell if it was the herbicide working or its natural life cycle. And in fact, the next year, some did come back. I had to reapply the herbicide the second year. And indeed, the third year, there was still a little bit left. But after that third year of me applying an herbicide, finally, the fourth year, it never came back. So it is possible to do, but it takes some diligence and patience. Fortunately, once you've gotten rid of the lesser celandine, we've got some wonderful alternatives that will give some wonderful bright spring color to your yard. Our first alternative of a native plant to plant instead of lesser celandine is Chrysogonum virginianum, green and gold. Green and gold is a pretty little ground cover that will last all season long, not just during spring. It forms a nice dense mat that will be around all season long. In spring, this is very early spring right now when we're filming this, but it is just starting to give its pretty little yellow star-shaped flower blooms, and it'll get more and more that'll last really nicely throughout spring into June, and then through the rest of the summer, it'll still even give a few little blooms throughout. It can take sun through shade. The sunnier it is, the more likely it is to want some more water. But it's a great plant that makes a great native ground cover as a replacement for lesser celandine. If you really like the looks of lesser celandine, then you're in luck because we've got a great look-alike native replacement, marsh marigold or cowslip, Caltha palustris. The sweet buttercup-like flowers can grow 12 to 18 inches high. It's also an early bloomer with bright shiny yellow flowers and glossy heart-shaped leaves. It likes moist to wet soil and is not palatable to deer or rabbits. We're in my own driveway at my own home to show you the third replacement for lesser celandine. This is Pachyra aurea, golden ragwort. It's a wonderful native ground cover that I call my silver bullet because it is good for almost every situation. It takes sun, it takes shade, it's semi-evergreen, and it once a year gives these beautiful golden blossoms. It's just starting to bloom right now, but you can see how bright and happy these little sunflower-like flowers are. Once it's done blooming, it'll make little thistle-like seed heads that'll blow around, and that is actually the biggest problem with it. It is that it spreads relatively aggressively. But if you've got a large area that you would like covered with a nice hardy native ground cover, golden ragwort is a great answer for you. Whichever native plant you choose to replace lesser celandine, I wish you happy gardening.